Pascaline of Pascal's calculator. Pascaline was the world's first mechanical calculator invented by French mathematician and philosopher Blaise Pascal in 1642. There are input dials and output windows on the top of the Pascaline. Inside each of the dials, we can see a small drum with digits 0 to 9 written on it. Each drum has two rows of numbers, one below the other. Every time when an addition takes place, the top row of the output windows are covered with a horizontal slat. Through the bottom windows, you can see the results of the addition. The top row shows you 9th complement numbers, which helps you in doing subtraction. Each input dial is divided into 10 parts using spokes. In order to enter a digit you need, put a stylus into the middle of appropriate spokes. You need to rotate the spokes clockwise till the spokes you rotate reaches the metal indicator or fixed stop located at the bottom of the dials. Entering numbers consecutively in the dials displays their sum on the output windows. For example, if we want to add 38 plus 42, the first thing to do is entering the numbers 3 and 8 in the rightmost dials respectively, like this. Basically, this is the row of ones and this is the row of tens. I entered 3 in the tens place by putting the stylus in the appropriate place and rotating it clockwise until the fixed stop is reached. That will show the value 3 in the output window in the tens place. Same procedure is to be followed to enter 8 in the ones place. Put the stylus in the correct place and rotate the spokes until it shows 8 in the output window on ones place. To add 42 with 38, you have to dial 42 with 38 using the same procedure. In the tens place, we have 3. We need to add 4 to that. Move the spoke near 4 clockwise till it reaches the fixed stop. That makes the value in the tens place 7. Now we need to add 2 in the ones place. For that, rotate the spoke near 2 till it reaches the fixed stop. That will make the value in the ones place 0 and it automatically adds 1 to the 7 in the tens place, making the value in tens place as 8. That happens because the value of 8 plus 2 is 10. The digit 0 stays in the ones place and carries the 1 to the tens place, making the value in the tens place as 8, which is 7 plus 1. Same like normal addition. So we got the value 80 in the Pascaline, and that is the right answer. In order to start a new series of addition or subtraction, you need to clear the value which is already stored in a Pascaline. The clearing is done by setting all the input values to 9 and adding 1 to the digit in the lowest order in the Pascaline. You can set all the dials to 9 by moving the marked spokes in each dial clockwise towards the fixed stop. Adding 1 to the lowest order number actually causes a carry and sets all the output window values to 0. We can do subtraction with the Pascal's calculator by moving the horizontal slat to uncover the top row of output windows. That unveils a row of digits with 9th complement values. If you want to subtract 50 from 80, you have to pull the slat down to unveil the 9th complements. Now, you have to enter the 9th complement of the minuend. Minuend is the number from which another number is to be subtracted. Here, the minuend is 80. If you don't remember the 9th complement of every number, don't worry. You can place the stylus in the middle of the specially marked spokes and rotate clockwise till it reaches the number you wish to enter. So we entered 80 in that manner. After entering 80 using the specially marked spokes in the Pascaline, we need to enter 50 in the normal way. When we enter 5 in the tens place, 3 is displayed in the output window. In ones place, we don't have to enter any number because the value to be entered in the ones place is 0. So the value in the ones place is 0 while subtracting 50 from 80. That displays the answer in the output windows, that is 30. We learned to do addition and subtraction with the Pascaline today. Let us know if you want to know anything more about the Pascaline in the comment section below. For more such interesting content, join the Knowledge Tribe on Facebook and Instagram, or tweet to us at KnowTheTribe and subscribe to our YouTube channel.